Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. And a very good morning to all of my students. Welcome to my lecture. Again, for this time, of course, we're going to cover topic 5, chapter 5, where this topic is involved with belt drive and way to calculate, you know, the power transmitted, torque, and of each pulley, and so on and so forth. Yeah. And in our previous video, we got two parts of video where we discuss a lot about the theory behind the belt drive, where the type of belt drive, the application, and any implications such as like worn out, the belt worn, the creep, and the belt loose, and so on, is also discussed in our previous video. So I think you guys can check out throughout my video, I think, and I believe they got two parts of it. So one of it is already uploaded in my YouTube channel, and I'm going to upload the first version or the first part tomorrow. Yeah, so bear with me. So by now, this is more or less about tutorial where we want to discuss some past year question on how to solve the belt drive kind of problem, and how we going to solve it. Yeah, so eventually this is the question. Yeah, so this is more or less is topic 4. Topic 5 and question 4. Okay, you got like 3 questions, A, B, C, and question C got it been divided by another 3 sub questions. Yeah, so for question 4A, they ask you kind of like a theoretical question. Yeah, state 5 important factors, yeah, in selecting belt drive. Okay, so you can, you know, you can check out my video. More or less the solution is already stated here. It stated that more or less the important factor that select in order to select the belt drive, you have to look at in terms of the power to be transmitted, the center distance between shaft, speed reduction ratio, speed of driving and driven shaft, and service conditions. Yeah, so these 5 is all the factors that needed to be considered in order to select optimal way of selecting the belt drive. Yeah, okay, so more or less we already done with question 4A done. Okay, so we go to question 4B. Question 4B asks you to, they ask you to determine the necessary length of belt. So determine the length of belt to drive a pulley of 500 centimeter diameter. Okay, to drive a pulley of 500 centimeter. Okay, a pulley of 500 centimeter. This one, okay, is equivalent to 500 centimeter. Of course, more or less, we have to change it into meter to make it better and easier to calculate in overall process. Okay, and then to drive a pulley of 500 centimeter diameter, running parallel at the distance of 10 meter from the driving pulley of diameter 70 centimeter. Okay, this system is closed belt drive. Of course, for this kind of question, I think more or less, first of all, I think you have to drive. And sorry, my bad. You have to, what you call that? You have to draw the free body diagram, you know, in order to see or to check the understanding of yourself throughout the question. So basically, they want to know what is the length of the belt to drive a pulley of 500 centimeter in diameter. So let's say this is a pulley that have a diameter of 500 centimeter. Okay. And running parallel, distance of, okay, let's say the distance is supposed to be around, okay, 10 meter. Okay. With a diameter of 70 centimeter. So here, got diameter is 70 centimeter. Okay. So question is, you want to know what is the length of your belt? They don't know what is the length. Supposedly the length to be in meter unit, yeah. Okay. So how are we going to solve this problem? So overall, I bet you guys already have a good background or have a good check. Yeah, or you have a good view what the problem that you are dealing with. Yeah, so again, I'm explaining to you guys, you know, for this question 4B. Yeah, they want to know what is the length of the belt that the belt is designed to drive a pulley of 500 centimeter. Okay, 500 centimeter. And running parallel at distance of 10 meter, okay. And then the driving pulley is 70 meter, something like this, yeah. So very easy, I think. Okay, in order to determine the necessary length of belt, here is the what you call that, equation. More or less you have to understand the equation, what sort of equation that you need to use to solve the problem. So first of all, x is diameter, the length between the two pulleys, and then of course d1 is the pulley that been driven, all right? And then 2.5 meter, I'll check after. And 70 centimeter is the driven pulley. Yeah. And then, oh yeah, this one is just a radius. Yeah. This one is just 70, you know, divided by 2. You got this one is 70 centimeter. Yeah. Divided by 2, you got 35. Centimeter, then you change it to meter, 1, 2, then you got 0.35 meter. So this one and this one is just a radius, nothing much, you know, won't be that hard to understand. So the formula is stated here very clear, where cos, this one, you know, cos alpha or cos whatever sign is here, is equivalent to R1 plus R2 divided by D. What is D? D is the distance between pulley. D is the distance between pulley. Here is this distance. Okay. All right. That is the distance. So basically, once you manage to equate this sort of equation, you manage to get the angle to be in radians, supposed to be 73.44 degrees or equivalent to 1.28 radian. Okay. And then angle 1 is equivalent to angle 2, equivalent to 2 pi minus 2 alpha 1. So you know your pi is easy to find, 3.421, you know, easier. You multiply by 2 and then you minus with 2, you multiply by this one. Okay, or this one. make it more easier, then you manage to get 3.718 radian. All right. L, as we shown here, L is equivalent to R1 multiplied by theta 1 plus R2 multiplied by theta 2 plus 2 multiplied by sin theta. So just equate all those numbers, you know, just insert it into the equation. Then somehow you manage to get L to be 29.77 meter. Okay. X basically, this X is the distance, 10 meter, the distance between these two pulley. Yeah, this 10 meter. Okay. So I think everything is already stated. So it's quite simply just a straightforward kind of solution to solve this kind of problem. Yeah. Okay. I move on into question 4C. Okay. Question 4C. So what is question 4C? An open belt drive connects two pulley, 2.4 meter and 1 meter diameter, on parallel distance 4 meter apart. Okay, got distance of 4 meter. The mass of belt is 0.9 kilogram meter and the maximum tension is not exceed 2500 newton. The coefficient of friction is 0.3. The small pulley, which is driver, runs at 400 RPM. So they want you to calculate centrifugal tension, the power transmitted, the torque on each pulley. Okay. How to solve? See, calculate the centrifugal tension. So basically, this is the input given, you know, throughout the question. You got X is 4 meter here. X is 4 meter, the distance, yeah, 4 meter, 4 meter. Clear, eh? X is 4 meter. D1 is the diameter, is 2.4 meter. 2.4 meter, yeah, two pulley, 2.4 meter and 1 meter diameter. So here you got 2.4 meter and 1 meter diameter. Of course, you're going to change it into radius. Okay. So first of all, of course, they give you the torque. The torque is 2500 newton. The torque. Yeah, no, the tension. The maximum tension is not exceed 2500 newton. So this is the kind of like this one is kind of like limit load, kind of, yeah. This one is sort of like limit load, which means that you can exceed this sort of limit. Okay. So the mass is 0.9 kilogram over meter. Let's check. Does it sounds right or not? Yeah. 0.9 kilogram over meter for the mass, yeah. This one mass is 0.9 kilogram meter. Clearly there. Okay, mu of course is the friction. Mu is the friction, and n is the 400 RPM. Means how it runs, the velocity. Yeah, n is 400. RPM. So it's what you call that, it crank and cycle to the speed of 400 revolution per minute. Yeah. Okay. So Once all the input is already stated clearly, what you have to do is just find out the equation. So first of all, the velocity. Okay, clearly here, the velocity equivalent to omega r. Omega is the velocity in what? Not in linear lah, is velocity in rotational. Okay. V is velocity in linear. Okay. So V equivalent to omega r. So we know omega is 2 pi times 400 divided by 60. 400 is RPM. 400 RPM, the N. And multiply by R, 0.5. Why R 0.5? Here we see. Radius 1, radius 2. Okay. So you manage to get, you know, once you already got the you insert all the input, then you manage to get the velocity, the linear velocity to be 20.94 meter per second. Yeah. So now, interestingly, this is a new question. This is a new equation, more or less. This one, you guys kind of familiar with it, you know, mostly you guys seeing it for quite some time throughout the course. Why for this one? I think this is kind of like new equation for you guys. So, no worries. We'll see how does it going to help you to solve this problem. So, TC is the tension of the belt or the limit tension of the belt, maybe. And then going to equivalent to M multiplied by V power of 2. So, you know, M is mass. You know, mass is 0.8. Mass is 0.9. Then you multiply with V velocity. The linear velocity is 20.94. And then directly you got TC equivalent to 39.64 Newton. And what is TC? TC is a centrifugal tension. Centrifugal tension. So this is kind of like new equation for you. Just follow this equation, remember, and then I bet you easily to solve it. Okay. Number two, Roman, the power transmitted. More or less, they want to know what is the power transmitted from this one, and then they transmit the power through the bigger pulley. How? So the formula is quite same with the question for A or not question for B. You know, cos theta equivalent to R1 minus R2 divided by D. Okay. So at the end of the day, then you manage to get theta to be 2.789 radian and angle to be 1.3839 radian. Yeah. Okay, this is all mathematics. And then this is like kind of like new equations. This is sort of like new equation that you guys need to understand lah. I mean, to remember, to understand in order to solve the problem. I'm not sure either given throughout the exam or not, but I think it's a good thing for you to remember, yeah? So T1, you know, minus T2 divided T2 minus TC. Sorry, T1 minus TC divided by T2 minus TC. So we already know the TC. So we want to know T1. T1, of course, the tension, the limit load, you know. And TC is a centrifugal. So we don't know T2. Okay. E, basically, the exponent. Mu. This one, sorry, mu On the other hand, mu is a symbol of friction, and then theta is theta. Okay, so you insert it throughout this equation, then you got T2, which is 1306.55 Newton. Okay, so the formula for power is power equivalent to T1 minus T2 and multiply by velocity. So T1 is 2500 Newton minus to T2 minus with T2, which is T2 is 1306.55 Newton, and then multiply by 20.94, which is we got from the velocity. Then the power managed to get about 24,990.84 watt. Yeah, so that is the power. So we're done with this question. Yeah, okay, we're done. All right. So lastly, I want to calculate the torque of on each pulley. Eh? So basically, the torque on larger pulley is T1, you know, minus T2 multiplied by R1. So here is the formulation: T1 equivalent to this one is already you already have lah. Yeah, this one is T1, this one is T2, multiplied by R1. R1 is what? R1 here is the radius of pulley. Okay, this one is a radius of pulley. Whatever pulley lah. If you want to go by larger pulley, then you go by 1.2, basically it's 2.4. Yeah, the diameter is 2.4 meter, and then of course the radius is 1.2 meter, you know, it's in here. So the torque supposed to be around 1432.14 Newton meter. Okay, why for the small pulley, you know, 0.5, yeah, it's about, you know, this one, and the torque on for small pulley. So you going to equate it, then you manage to get torque to be around 596.73 Newton meter. Yeah. So that's it. That's how you solve this kind of problem. It's not that difficult. I think it's quite straightforward. What you need to do is you have to understand the question. Of course, you have to kind of like know which equation they have to use to solve the problem. Then I think afterward, you need to you need to know what is the problem. So basically, the free body diagram is quite important. It's very critical for you to understand the problem that you're trying to solve, and then you're trying to draw it throughout free body. You know, throughout free body diagram. Yeah, since free body, having the free body diagram is going to give you a very clear view on how to solve the problem. Yeah. So that's it from me. I think if I got some time, I'm going to record another video for chapter 5 of course. Yeah. Then by this time, I'm going to do some revision throughout past your questions. Yeah, so if you guys got any queries or difficulty to understand the questions or to solve the problem or for your preparation to deal with your final exam, then please do contact me and I will be gladly to help you or to assess you in any time, inshallah. So till next time, semoga berjumpa lagi. I hope you do your best. And please do contact me or do refer me if got any difficulties throughout. Yeah. So good luck. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Bye bye.